opening day of bow season, September 14th. We're heading out to the food plot, and hopefully we can get one.
What that goes on brings the big box steps.
Yeah. Hopefully no more telemarketers call me on a Saturday, right? Well, it's opening night of bow season here in Wisconsin. We're sitting on our white rack herd out of the nutrition annual plot. It's full of radish and turnip and beets and all kinds of good stuff in there. We got that in the first week of June, and it's really mature now. It's really nice. It looks like a patch of weeds, but it's not. It's all the turnip and the radish and everything all matured and headed out, and it's all pushed a bunch of stems with a bunch of seeds all over it, so it looks like a bunch of tall weeds, but really when you walk it, it's all loaded full of good stuff down there. The radish and the turnips are really nice, so they're going to pay off this December, end of November, December, January, when it's real cold, and deer are going to need it. But we've got a lot of decent deer coming through this food plot, this long cigarette one that we planted, like I said. And sitting in the blind tonight with Blake, and Blake's gonna shoot basically whatever he wants, unless it's a fawn, obviously, but he said he wants a green light on anything, so we should draw some blood tonight. Hopefully we can get one on the ground. Change of plans. We're gonna ground hunt. The mosquitoes are coming out because it's warming up, but the wind died down, which really sucks. Last night I was out here and three smaller bucks came out. One was a decent 8-pointer, so Blake wants to try to get after him tonight. So we're holed up here in these pine trees, and these bucks have been coming out of this bedding, going through these pine trees in this alfalfa field behind us. So when the bucks come out in this field, Blake and I are going to make a ground stalk, and we're going to go at them down through the pine trees here and try to get one on the ground for them. So we'll see how it goes. right behind you. Like, right behind you, and I saw you and, like, took off running like hell.
He was, like, right here. Like, right here.
Down the hill yet. I knew there was a buck because I heard one running around. We're gonna stay right where we're at and watch this hill, okay?
Thank you.
Well, it's the end of October, and we're going out again tonight to the same farm. We went out last night, and the weather was horrible. It was 40-mile-an-hour gusts, and the wind is all just got the blind all jacked up. So we're heading out over the food plot tonight. We saw 3 bucks and 4 does yesterday. Nothing real big, but a nice buck that Blake would have shot if we could have got it in range. They took the cornfield off by the food plot, so I'm hoping that the deer are going to move early and try to get in there and get whatever corn is laying on the ground. So we're heading out tonight. It's 4:15. We've got about 2 hours of light to shoot once we get into the blind. It just sucks that the days get so short here in October, but you make the best of what you got. So hopefully we get a buck to come in tonight or a doe. I'm sure Blake will shoot either one, so hopefully he gets a shot at one.
Yep. My birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we never took it out. That bacon wrap.
Oh, yep, bacon wrap.
It's not the same buck. It is that little 7. Yeah. He's going back into the brush. go out the farm. It's October 25th. Kelly's all fired up, set this morning. Saw some, didn't shoot anything. That's okay. It's good intel on the camera. So hopefully we can get one of these bucks that are slipping up at first daylight, get them coming out tonight. Right, bud? Mm-hmm. We almost got one the other night, didn't we?
Yep, got a little crazy.
Yeah, it was close. Epic. Let's get back in that stand. So tonight we're going after the Velvet Four. So the Velvet Four is a little 5 or 6 pointer that held his velvet on for a long time. And we just nicknamed him the Velvet Four. So Blake's wanting to go after him, so we're gonna try it. He came out down this fence line twice now, two nights in a row. So we're hoping that he does it again tonight, and we're gonna try a ground and pound and ambush him on that fence line. And hopefully Blake can get a shot at him. Hit him good, put him on the ground. So, wish us luck.
He went down towards the middle of the field. I can't see him. He was over here coming through the brush, coming across. Like down in the middle. He's out here at like 50 yards, 60 yards below the hill right here. I don't think it was him. I think it was a different buck.
Probably.
Did you see it?
No, I just saw you like slam down your seat. I'm like, oh man, big buck, big buck.
Well, we figured out where our buck went tonight, right?
Yep.
Two nights in a row he comes up on this hill. We're sitting in the blind. Tonight, we're on the hill. And he's 60 yards away from the blind.
Yep.
Cat and mouse, right? Just when you think you got him figured out, they do this. Yeah, next time we'll just wait him out by the blind.
And the blind's a good spot.
Yeah.
He's got fawns coming in, but...
Yep.
Just gotta get a bigger deer in there.
Yep. It's November 1st. Blake and I are heading out to the farm we bought out in Vernon County. And we're going to do a little guys weekend out there. Kelly's going to stay home and do some stuff with her sisters. Hopefully Blake can get a shot on a nice buck. We haven't been out here in a couple weeks. We have no idea what's been cruising in or what's been cruising out. We're going to go out tomorrow morning, hunt for a while, check the cameras, warm up, and then go back out and do some more hunting. So see what's going on, see what kind of activities we got on the property, and hopefully Blake can kill one.
get to the hotel, going through all the camera gear, getting ready to pack the bags for the morning. Hotel motel life, right, Blake? It'll be a fast 2 days here at the farm, but it'll be worth it, right?
Yep.
Right.
Later. It's a big one. Hopefully we'll come back out. park, get some work done, and then we'll get showered and everything right after lunch and come back out and sit the rest of the day. Yeah. Sound good? Okay, good.
All right, it is 1:45, Saturday afternoon, November 2nd. We are heading back out to the farm, and I rattled in a nice 9-pointer this morning for Blake. He came in close. It was close. A little bit more and we would have had him, but he smelled a rat and he went back to where he came from, so that's okay. But we've been checking the cameras, and a lot of activity on our place during the middle of the day and afternoon. We had some work to do this afternoon, so we took care of that, and we're heading back out early, and hopefully I can rattle in another one for Blake, or we can get one to come check this scrape line that we're sitting on. So fingers crossed, nice buck comes in for Blake tonight, and he can put a arrow through it.
Free stand?
Yeah, I think we should try to gamble on sitting in that stand. I don't know if we should. With this wind coming off where the neighbors are working over there, I mean, they're only 40 acres away of whatever they're planting. I don't know what they're planting, but I don't know. I don't like the wind. The wind's going to be pushing, like, I don't know. I don't know what to do. We are sitting over scrapes, though. I don't know if we should gamble and just try to sit over those scrapes. Go in the back. What do you think?
Okay. We saw that big nine.
He went back in there. He's back in the back. There's no way he crossed the road with those people working. He went down to the river and then he went south, down into the jungle.
And then I want to sit in the back.
You want to try the back? You might as well, right?
Yeah, tomorrow you can try the front.
Yeah, you can take your arms off.
It's gonna be 30. Oh, he's gonna be farther.
There's a bigger one.
Yeah, he's farther. He's too far. He's too far. He'll come back. That was Blade. Just keep an eye on him. He'll come back, okay? They're gonna follow that doe. That doe's looking to the left, okay? Sit real still. See that doe going up the middle?
Yeah.
The little buck's on the left, the bigger one's on the right, following the doe. he's gonna go where that hot dough is. It's okay, he's gonna follow the scent.
It is Sunday morning, November 3rd. It is cold out. It's like 25 degrees, 21 with the wind chill. We're going back in the same set as yesterday morning, and we rattled in a nice 9-pointer yesterday morning, so hopefully I'll come back in this morning and Blake can put him on the ground.
Well, it was a quick, short weekend out here at the farm. We'll be back up this week. We gotta go home for a couple days, take care of some stuff. We saw some nice deer moving. They're just starting to get going. I think it's a tad early yet because we're still seeing does with yearlings and no bucks with them. So it tells me they're not getting bothered too much yet, but it's coming. I think next week is gonna really be fired up. So we'll be back up next week and hopefully Kelly can shoot a nice one, or Blake for that matter. Blake will be up on the weekend, Kelly and I will be up all week, so fingers crossed, it's go time.